Hi students.
Class 7, Chapter 6, The Triangle and Its Properties. So, let's start with the introduction. Introduction is about triangle. What is a triangle? So, you can say a closed figure surrounded by three sides. Okay? So, this is a closed figure which is surrounded by three sides. We can name it. If you name it, so this is triangle A, B and C. A, B, C ho gaya. And then if you talk about the part of the triangles, so it has how many sides? Sides of a triangle are three. How many sides? Side A, B, side B, C, side C, A, or you can say A, C, whatever. So A, B, B, C and C, A. Number two comes angles. If you talk about angles, so we have three angles, angle A, angle B and angle C. So, yahan pe agar hum, if you write angles, then you have got angle A, angle B and angle C. And if we talk about ye, what is this? This is a vertex where two lines meet at one point. This is a vertex of a triangle. So, this another vertex and this is another vertex. So, we have three vertices. Plural, then it becomes vertices. So, vertices are vertex A, vertex B and vertex C. So, this is the basic definition of a triangle. So, we can say a triangle is a three-sided polygon which has three sides, three angles and three vertices. That's it. So, this is our triangle. Going to study about median of a triangle. To know median of a triangle, we will do a paper activity which is very simple and easy to understand the concept. So, what I am going to do here, I have taken a triangle cutout, and then what I am going to do, I am trying to get the midpoint of one side, and one by one I'll get all the midpoints of all sides. So, first to get the one side, so we don't get confused, I am putting stickers in both the vertices. These two are vertices. So, I am putting sticker, one is red and the other one, so that we can easily find out which side we have folded. So, now we will fold it. I have folded it. So, like this from, so you get a crease, squeeze it properly and you get a crease. So, where you have got the crease at the bottom of the line, that is your midpoint, means this crease is dividing this line, this side into two equal parts. Okay, so if you have to name the triangle, like triangle ABC, okay, name ABC, so BC is divided into two equal parts by this crease, what crease we have created. And if you join this point, which is we have got by folding the paper, and join this point, you get the median and name it as D. So, the line, the line joining the midpoint to the opposite vertex is median of a triangle. So, here we can say that median divides the line into two equal parts. So, here you can see that BD is equal to DC, because D is the midpoint of side BC. So, this is divided into two equal parts, and AD is the bisector of side BC. That's it. This line is called median. AD is called median from vertex A, right? Isi tarah se, in the same way, if you find out middle point of this, so here this is a midpoint, you can name it. Suppose that I am naming it as this was our D point. Now we say it, so here you get a midpoint. And so this is your point E, a vertex C, say if you draw, this is your midpoint of line AB, or if you join this line, so this is the median from vertex C of line AB, right? Isi tarah se, you can find out the third midpoint of it, third midpoint of line AC. So you get a point here, that is middle point, which is dividing it into two equal parts. So now we'll name it as F, or ye point F, we are going to join this F to B from vertex B. So we got another median, right? So these are three medians. We have got three medians. So there is a question which says, how many medians can a triangle have? So as you saw, there can be only three medians in a triangle. This is the answer. By this activity, you found that there are three medians in a triangle. Or the next question of page number 114 of your notebook is, says, does a median lie wholly in the interior of the triangle? What is the interior of the triangle? This whole part is the interior of the triangle. Okay, and all the medians are lying inside triangle. So yes, it is true. So by this activity, we had solved both the questions of this think, discuss and write section. There was question number one, how many medians can a triangle have? The answer is, there are three medians a triangle can have. Question number two, does a median lie wholly in the interior of the triangle? Yes. So that's it. Now, let's conclude how many medians can a triangle have. So, uske liye suppose that this is an angle, this is a triangle which has three vertices A, B, C, or ye iska midpoint hai, which is D, this is another midpoint E, and this is another midpoint F. So the line joining the midpoints of from the vertex, opposite vertex of the line is median. And similarly, if you join point B to midpoint of line AC, this is this. And if you join draw a line from this to this, so you have got three medians of a triangle. So there are a number of the triangle, the number of medians in a triangle is three. Okay. So here you can say altitude of a triangle. What is altitude? So here I have taken a cutout, cardboard cutout of a triangle. So if you put this on a table or on a flat surface, you see the height of this triangle. This is the height, as you can see, height. This height, height, how do we measure height of anybody, anything or any place or whatever? So bottom to top, so this, as you can see, this is 14. So this is the height of a triangle, is altitude of a triangle. So if you name again, ab ye triangle liya humne, we have taken a triangle, iske bhi naam de dete hain, we'll take any name x, y and z. So vertex x se leke jiska perpendicular hai, what is the perpendicular height, right? Perpendicular means at 90 degree, bilkul straight. So that height, you can name anything x, y, let's see, we can say l. So this one, that is at 90 degree. So the height from vertex x is 14 centimeter. So here you can say this is 14 centimeter, and this is altitude of a triangle. If you take like this, so now this will be your vertex, another vertex. Suppose that this is y vertex, this is x vertex, this is z. So if you take the altitude from vertex y, you get 15 centimeter. This you can say, if you take altitude means the perpendicular height of a triangle from vertex, this is your 15 centimeter. So the next question is, how many altitudes can a triangle have? page number 15, think, discuss and write. That is the section. It asks how many altitudes can a triangle have. So the answer is 3. Here you saw, agar if you draw an altitude from here, again it's perpendicular, then you'll get another height which will be of 21 centimeter. So you saw okay, there are 3. So you can say number of altitudes can a triangle have is 3. Okay, question number 2 of page number 115 says, draw rough sketches of altitude from A to BC for the following triangles. There are 3 triangles given. One is acute angle triangle, another is right angle triangle, and the third one is obtuse angle triangle. Going to do, we are going to draw a perpendicular line. So that is altitude. So this altitude is, you can name it as AL. So this is the altitude, or since it is 90 degree, so this line is altitude of angle right angle triangle, and here you can draw. So this will be outside the triangle. How? Because from vertex A, we need to draw from vertex A. Vertex A is outside. So this is the altitude of triangle ABC, which is obtuse angle triangle. So this is your altitude for question number 2. So here, so this is vertex, and they are asking to draw an altitude of line to line BC, and BC is ending here, but we need to draw an altitude from vertex A. So it is this, and you can name it like whatever you name, AM, you can say AM. So this is your altitude. Question, will an altitude always lie in the interior of a triangle? Question number 3 says, will an altitude always lie in the interior of the altitude? Here you can see, with this question, by solving only this question, you can find the answer of question number 3. So the answer is no, because in this obtuse angle triangle, you can see the altitude is outside the triangle. This is outside the triangle, exterior, which is called exterior. What is interior and exterior? This part is known as, which is surrounded by 3 lines. This area, this region is known as interior. This part is your interior, which comes in means the surrounded part of the triangle is interior part, and outside part, this whole region is as an exterior. So this is exterior of the triangle. Okay, and here also in this triangle, this is, this part is interior and this is exterior, from here to here all exterior, and then this is on the triangle, these 3 lines. If you draw anything on it, this like this, and this on the line BC, on line AC, on line AB, then that is on the triangle. Okay, for the altitude, we will do the exercise in next video, exercise 6.1. So do not forget to check the video, that is next video, which will be based on exercise 6.1. Thank you. Thanks for watching.